Hi, welcome back. If indeed you are coming back, if you're a first timer, hello, welcome. Today, I am going to talk to you about four mindset tips for you. Okay. Now, these are they're sort of directed at writers, but if you're an illustrator, these will be helpful as well. Or even if you're any kind of creative, I think these mindset tips will be helpful for you. All right. If you don't know who I am, I'm Jen Storer. I'm a children's author, and I also run girlandduck.com, where I nurture, guide, and connect kidlit creators. Kidlit meaning children's literature. All right. Now, since I've been running Girl and Duck, the thing that I've realized the most is that what people need the most is mindset help. They need help and support, because this is such a long game, all right? And a lot of people don't realize that when they first get involved in the creation of beautiful children's books, they don't realize what a commitment it is. It is a long game, and during that time, we need a lot of support. And not only is it a long game, it also brings up a lot of demons within us. And that's not because it's children's literature. It's because any form of creativity, when you embark on a creative journey as an adult, it challenges us. It really does. We come up with against all sorts of, for want of a better term, creativity blocks. All right. Creativity stories that we have around creativity and our permission to create. These sorts of stories come up constantly, and they're not things that we can deal with once and put aside and think, okay, tick that box, dealt with my creativity blocks, and now I can just get on with the work. All right. It's not like that. This is an ongoing process. So these are four tips that I've got for you today. And I'm thinking I'll probably do a series on this, because there's so many tips that we can utilize in terms of our mindset and creativity. But today I want the first tip I want to give you is an oldie but a goodie, and it is progress, not perfection. Progress, not perfection. Please commit to that one tip. In fact, that one tip, if you take that on board, will help you every single day of your creative life. Probably your whole life, actually. Progress, not perfection. Progress, not perfection was the very first post that I ever put in the Girl and Duck Facebook group. I think it was either late 2015 or early 2016 when I opened that Facebook group, which has now become this beautiful membership site. That's called the Duck Pond. So that was the very first post, because I was like, I don't know what to put in here. What am I going to say to all these people? You know, what am I going to post? And so I thought, okay, progress, not perfection, Jen, for me and for everybody here. So if you commit to that, if you put aside this desire to be perfect, and within that context, I like to say to everybody, allow yourself to rehearse. In all walks of life, we allow ourselves to rehearse, whether we're going to speak publicly, whether we're going to do a reel on Instagram. Lately, I've been having a lot of fun doing reels on Instagram, and I have to rehearse them. I can't get the lip sync perfect. I can't get it even near right first time. I have to rehearse. And at the end of the day, none of the reels are perfect, but they're good enough. So this is what we have to allow ourselves to do with our writing and with our illustration. We have to grant ourselves time to rehearse. We're not going to get it perfect, and we're not going to make it something that we're really proud of from the first time up. But as adults, we tend to fall into this trap, particularly with writing. There's a particular thing about writing that for some reason, adults seem to think that the only thing between them and their novel or them and their picture book is time. You know, if I can just get the time and sit down and I'll do it. No, it's not about just about time. It's about your mindset, and it's about accepting the fact that the first things you write will not be very good at all, I'm afraid, because you need to rehearse. You need to rehearse. So progress, not perfection. Go gently. Be gentle with yourself. Allow yourself the time to practice. That's what a draft is. It's a rehearsal. Even within your story, you're going to be rehearsing your actors. You're going to be a casting manager. You're going to be making decisions about who's in and who's out, you know, who's working and who's not working. The whole thing, it's all about rehearsing. Progress, not perfection. Don't rush. Go gently. Be gentle with yourself. So that's the first one. Progress, not perfection, and allow yourself to rehearse. Tip number two is set the bar low. I have always, throughout my writing career, and I've got 23 published books at the moment, published with HarperCollins and Penguin, I have always set the bar low. I never sit down to write a book. I always sit down to write 500 words. 500 words is so nothing, all right? And it's just such a low bar. But I allow myself that low bar so that when I hit that I can feel really good about myself. And then if I'm having a particularly good day or I've got a little bit more time, I'll stay there and I'll write more than 500 words. And sometimes my 500 words will evolve into 1,000 words. But that's not what I'm striving for. When I sit down to write, I'm always writing 500 words because books are written step by step. Baby step by baby step. It's about repetition. It's about consistency. Okay. So if the bar is low, you're less likely to be terrified when you sit down. You're not taking on too much. Now, within the context, I just printed out this here. I have a middle grade course, middle grade magic and e-course. And within that, I literally help people set their writing goals. And there's a printout, there's a little form, and I ask people to set the bar of 500 words 5 days a week. I don't want to ever hear from anyone who's writing every day of their life. All right, let's just contain this 5 days a week, 500 words a day. And one of our lovely members, this is a couple of years ago when I first ran the course, put this photo in the Facebook group of her weekly tally. Okay, week one, week two, week three. And look at that. She set her bar at 500 words. And most days she got a little bit over, but basically around that. One day she got 499, bless her. And then at the end of those 3 weeks, she had 8,133 words. 8,133 words. Can you see how it's cumulative? It's cumulative. That's what a novel is. That's what a story is. And they don't have to be perfect words, all right? Because progress, not perfection. Fix it later, fix it later, fix it later, fix it later. Don't forget that. Okay, so 500 words, set the bar low, turn up 5 days a week and see what happens. Even if you just do it for a month and see what happens. Because when you get to getting to that 8,133 words is such an achievement and it makes you feel so good. You know, and that's what we want to do in our mindset work. We want to always feel like we're making progress and we want to feel positive and we want to feel like we are nurturing our inner artist. We are nurturing our inner writer, not grappling with them or forcing them or disciplining them or being hard on them. All right. So tip number two, set the bar low, my darling. Ooh, there goes my phone. Number three. Focus in 50. I just recently shared this again on Instagram with a reel. If you don't follow me on Instagram, get over there and follow me because it's a lot of fun. You know, we're having a lot of fun over there. Focus in 50 is something that my own coach taught me. My business coach taught me focus in 50. And I'm not sure where she learned it or whether it was something, a phrase that she actually coined. But focus in 50 will really help you. Because it again, it's about setting the bar low. So you just set aside 50 minutes, not an hour, not an hour. You set aside 50 minutes, you sit down quietly, you set a timer, you literally set a timer. You turn off all your devices and all distractions, and you just dedicate 50 minutes to working on your project. And what you can achieve in 50 minutes is astounding. So many of us fall into the trap of thinking we need great swathes of time stretching out before us. We need to be in a cabin in the, you know, Rocky Mountains in order to write our novel. We get caught up in all this sort of palaver and romancing about how, you know, it's so, it requires, you know, the dedication of a nun or something to get this done. It doesn't. It doesn't. Give yourself 50 minutes a day and see what happens. All right. See if you can find that 50 minutes to just sit down quietly. Now, I was having trouble with a story I was writing a while ago, and a girlfriend came and visited me, and she is also an author. And I was fiddle farting around, you know, putting off, procrastinating, not getting into it. And she needed to get something finished because she had a deadline. And so she said to me, before we go out, because we were heading off to do, you know, lovely things, before we go out, let's do a focus in 50. And I'm like, okay. So we sat down, we were across the table from each other. Okay. So we sat down, and in those first few minutes of settling in, I wanted to talk. I wanted to interrupt. I wanted to dick around. Okay. But I could see her in front of me, and she was setting a good example for me because she was paying attention to what she was doing. So very resistantly, I was like, oh, okay, I'll do the focus in 50. Right. And of course, within that 50 minutes, I actually solved a plot problem that had been plaguing me for months. And it was only a little junior fiction story. Okay. Only. But I had been plagued by this plot problem for months, and which was probably what was affecting my procrastination, you know, because I was getting scared of the story. I was scared of not being able to fix it. I was scared of not being able to pull it off. But I needed to focus. I needed to grant myself that 50 quiet, gentle minutes to sit down and really see what I could do. Focus in 50 is a brilliant, brilliant mindset sort of device. It really, really does help you. So that's my third tip for today, is use Focus in 50, get familiar with Focus in 50, apply it and experiment with it and see how it works for you and see what happens in that Focus in 50. I bet you can get your 500 words in Focus in 50, right? Your daily quota, and you'll feel like the queen of your creativity if you can pull that off. Okay, and the fourth tip is a little bit more esoteric, but it comes from years and years of experience, from my experience of coaching and mentoring and supporting other writers and illustrators. And this is take ownership of your creativity. I'm looking down because my notes are written in this talkie-dokie book. And you may think I'm holding that up just for a joke. I'm not. Because take ownership of your creativity means allowing yourself to be a creative person. See yourself as creative and prioritize your creativity. All right. This, I came to this realization from years of experience of coaching people, because I see it time and time again. So many women, mostly I coach women, are reluctant to actually own their creativity. They feel guilty for wanting to be creative, as if it's some sideline thing, you know, that they can kind of shoehorn into their life. But what I'm saying is, don't do that. Except that if you have a calling to create, you are creative. And creativity should be central to your life, not on the periphery. Embrace your creativity. And creativity loves you to be playful, whether you're writing hardcore adult crime fiction or beautiful picture books about, you know, talking unicorns. Your creativity your inner artist is playful and joyful, and your inner artist likes to feel enchanted and likes not just a little section of your life to be enchanted, but your entire life to be enchanted. So my talky-docky notebook, which I bring to business meetings and everything, it is a result of my inner artist, my inner child saying, I love that. I want that in my life. You know, these sorts of things remind me that I am a creative, playful person who likes to experiment and push boundaries. The other thing about owning your creativity too is that so many creators first come to this field tentatively and afraid and second-guessing themselves because their mind is on not only on being published and getting a publishing contract, it's also on what publishers want. And that is not the place to start from, all right? That is not going to help you. That is going to undermine your confidence and make you strive for perfectionism right off the bat. It's going to really, really be a very heavy burden to carry. But if you can take ownership of your creativity, then you can start to create freely without second-guessing yourself. When you stand in your power as a creative, you are in control of this story. It's yours. It doesn't belong to a publisher yet. You can still have the goal of wanting to be published if that's one of your dreams. Of course you have, but you need to put that goal on the back burner and just be a creative and create. Create freely, be prepared to experiment, embrace progress, not perfection, embrace the rehearsal time, allow it to be as messy and as ugly as it wants to be, because eventually a mess leads to clarity. All right. So all, as you can see, all these four mindset tips, they all feed into one another. They're all part of the same puzzle, which is your big, beautiful brain and your soul, the soul that lights you up, okay, the creative soul that lights you up and brings you to these projects and begs of you to be creative, to embrace your creativity, to make your life a rich and enchanting experience. That's what this is all about. That's what it's all about. All right, so that's from me today, me and the talky-docky book. That's what I've got to bring to you today. And I hope you will join me again. If you haven't, please subscribe, leave a like, whatever. There's also the Girl and Duck podcast. If you wanted to listen to that, you can find that. It's all over on the Girl and Duck website, girlandduck.com. And loads of love from me today. I have a very low bar set. I'm going to write 500 words. Okay. Bye for now. I'll see you again soon.